हेलो गाइस, आई होप यू ऑल आर डूइंग गुड। वी आर डिस्कसिंग इलेक्ट्रोमैग्नेटिक्स और EMFT पार्ट, एंड इन दैट टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू टॉक अबाउट द रिलेशनशिप बिटवीन द इलेक्ट्रिक फील्ड इंटेंसिटी एंड द करेंट डेंसिटी। सो फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल यू शुड नो द इलेक्ट्रिक फील्ड इंटेंसिटी इज रिप्रेजेंटेड बाय E एंड द करेंट डेंसिटी इज रिप्रेजेंटेड बाय J. First of all, you should know what is current density. Okay, the current density is represented by J, as I have already told you. It is the current per unit area, as the name suggests. Okay, so if I have the area to be A and the current to be I, so as shown in this figure, so this is my resistor. R is representing my resistor of length L and area A and the resistivity rho. Okay, so this is the circuit. Here I have supplied some voltage. This is the positive voltage and this is the negative terminal, and the current I is going here. So if I want to find out the current density will be current divided by area A. So this is how current density can be found out. If I talk about the resistance, okay, so how I can find out the resistance? I hope you all know the formula to find out the resistance. It is given as rho L upon A. Okay, so rho is the resistivity, L is the length, A is the area. We all know this formula of resistance, R is equal to rho L upon A. Now we all know the Ohm's law as well. If I talk about the Ohm's law, according to the Ohm's law, V is given as I into R. Okay, so this is the voltage, this is the current, and this is the resistance, and this is how they are related according to the Ohm's law. Okay, so now if I talk about the relation between the V and E, because at last I have to find out the relation between E and J. Okay, so first of all I should know the relationship between V and E. So I know V is equal to minus integration of E dot dl. Okay, so now from here I can see the integration limits are from L to 0. Okay, so if I want to find out the electric field, I will be using this formula, and now you can solve this, and the integration of dl, I know it is L, so it is minus E L, and the integration limits are from L to 0. Okay, so now if I put the integration limits over here, I will be having minus E 0 minus L, which is equal to, if I solve it, it will be equal to minus E into minus L, which is equal to E into L. So this is my V. Okay, so now I know what is V, I know what is I know what is R. Let's put all of the values. So V is equal to E into L. What is I? I is equal to, if I find out I from here, I will be equal to J into A. Okay, so now J into A. Okay, so now if I talk about R, R is rho L upon A. Okay, so from here you can see this A and this A will get cancelled out, L and L will get cancelled out. So I can say E is equal to J into rho, or I can say if I have to find out the J, J will be equal to E upon rho. What was rho? Rho was the resistivity. 1 upon resistivity is conductivity. So I can say J is equal to sigma into E. If I take the directions also, J vector is equal to sigma E vector. Okay, so where sigma is the conductivity. and I have used the formula that 1 upon resistivity is equal to conductivity. We all know this formula. Now from here we deduce the relationship between the electric field intensity and the current density. We can see these are directly related because the conductivity for a given material will be constant. If I increase the electric field intensity, the current density will be increasing. And also I can deduce one more conclusion from here, which is that whatever the direction of electric field intensity, that would be the direction of current density. Or I can say the current density's direction is giving me the electric field's direction. Actually, the electric field is producing the current. So I have to say electric field intensity's direction is equal to current density's direction. Okay, so don't get confused here. And this relation is giving me actually the relationship between the network theory part, which you have already studied in the third semester, and your electromagnetics part. So this is how this was the relationship from the network theory and the EMFT. So here I will be concluding my session. I hope you understood each and everything. If you still have any doubt, let's put the doubt in the comment or contact me, reach out to me. I will be trying to help you. And I hope if you are liking this video, you will be pushing the like button, subscribing the channel, and also you will be sharing it with your friends. Thank you so much.